Hello and welcome back to another episode of Toy Therapy. I'm the host of Toy Therapist, aka Matthew Rent, and today I'm doing another Star Wars Black Series figure review. As you can see, I'm looking at Dryden Vos from the Solo A Star Wars movie, and I actually like this film. Really enjoyed it. It was better than I thought it was going to be. But yeah, it was a really good sort of type Western sort of like film. Yes, I if you check one of my older videos, I did a movie review of this. So if you got a bit of time, pop along to my older videos and have a look and see what you think of my review of Solo A Star Wars Movie. Oh, it's not a movie, Star Wars, Solo A Star Wars Story. Anyway, but enough about that. Let's just go around the particular box. So you get a nice picture there of Dryden Vos, which is played by Paul Bettany. You might know him in the Marvel films as Vision as well, and Jarvis as well. And I love his voice. He's got a very, very cool voice. And he can play bad guys really well and good guys really well. He can just flip it so, so well. And as you see, it's number 79. And you get a nice close-up of him there as well, with his scars there. And if you want to do a bit more reading on the back, you can, if you want to press pause. But anyway, let's get to the figure. So there is a Dryden Vos out of the packaging, and this figure is, I can't really pick any real holes in it. I'm really sort of struggling. There is going to be just the one thing I will pick out, but it's just more personal taste than anything else. But before I do that, I am going to show you his accessories. He does come with these sort of hand-to-hand weapons. If you remember in the film, they almost have like a laser type cutter as well, which was actually quite cool. And you get two of those because you use two of them in the film, and they slip onto hands really quite nicely and easily. It would be nice to have somewhere you can store those on the character, but you don't, so that's fine. I can live with that. Okay, so let's go through the articulation. So you get a nice head movement that does go all the way around. Okay, you are getting a really nice arm movement and rotation there as well, and you're getting a bit of a rotation on the old wrist. When it comes to his cloak, okay, that will come off, okay? So you can just have him just with the suit on, so you can take his cloak off if you want to, okay? And you do have the same movement with that as well, and a twist there. It is going to be a bit hindered because of the cloak itself. Okay, you do have a bit of a twist there on the old midriff, and nothing else there. And you're getting not bad leg movements, much better than Padme. Oh, mine's got a little bit of a problem, but mine can fix that. And you are getting a nice swivel there, that's on both. Okay, and you are getting a nice little tilt and up and down movement on the old foot. Okay, so for me at the moment, I'm not a big fan of these type of cloaks, but this actually does look nice. It does actually work for this particular figure. I think Padme and some other figures, it does or it doesn't, but I think this one actually works quite well. So I might even look into to see if someone, but I think it's because you've got this coming onto it as well, but I'm going to have a look into it and see if I can get an updated one. Overall, the actual sculpting is really on point. Redeeming feature really is that head, and the scarring, that is absolutely on point there. It's like they've taken some of the old Vision head sculpts and they just pop it onto there. But to be honest, though, Hasbro and their technology with comes to face sculpting, they are getting so much better every single time. And each time I see a figure, it's like I'm seeing more and more of the character in the actual figure there as well. But the painting there is really good. Like the scarring there, so bring it a bit closer. But you can see, this is for me at the moment, is the redeeming features. I don't really mind about the clothes much, even though everything is absolutely on point and perfect. I mean, even got like the lines in the trousers there. There we go. So you've got the lines in the trousers, and that is absolutely lovely. The knee joint is really nice as well, but it's not overcomplicated, and it is really, really good as well. So I've even got his little like wrist there as well. This wrist like communication device, which is quite cool. But for me, It just really does scream out Dryden Vos. It really does. It is a near perfect. It is practically perfect figure, and I do like the little touches with these as well. I might just put a bit of red, extra bit of red on there, just to look like it's glowing or something, or it's going to be used. But for me, like I said, everything about this, the head sculpt is so on point. The eyes are really good. The mouth, the nose. It is absolutely superb. I picked this up on from comics, not comics and cocktails, sorry, Star Action Figures, when I pre-ordered my Boba Fett Deluxe, which you've seen in a video. You'll see in a video, or you might have already seen it by now. And this was like $6.99. I wasn't really gonna pay full price for it because I just thought it'd be like a small character, but I mean, for the price, I thought an extra solo character. I thought, you know what, I might as well. And I'm glad I got him because that face sculpt is superb. But anyway, I can carry on talking about Paul Bettany and go on about that all day. I don't think no one would want to hear that. But this is Toy Therapy Seance. And next time, hopefully, you'll see some more figure reviews, my customs. I'm just going to try and get some more content out there as much as possible. So thank you very much for stopping by. Thanks for watching my content. Please remember to give me a like, share, subscribe. That'd be brilliant. And remember, drop a comment below. That'd be brilliant. And I will see you guys and girls again for the next figure review. Take care. Bye-bye.